Just about every application needs email at some point. Now, you may know how to send marketing emails, but how do you send emails from your own product? That's what we're going to do today by connecting Lovable and Resend. You ready? Let's go. Let's take a look at the project. You can see here I've got the Portland Shoe Company where somebody can fill out their name and their email address. When they do that, I want to send them a message. Now, just to keep it real simple, I'll also blind copy myself, and that will be my trace that they've contacted me. So how do we do this? Well, first of all, we need to ask Lovable to include Resend. So let's do that. I'm going to come over here and we'll say something like, add Resend to send an email when they fill out the form. Now, Lovable will actually pause and first ask me to connect with Supabase. Supabase is a way to do some backend functionality, but you can also do special things like storing secrets. The secret that I care about is my Resend API key. We're going to create that in a second, but usually when you're using a web service, it will give you an API key. That API key gives access to your whole account, so we want to make sure that that's somewhere secure, and that somewhere would be Supabase. So if I come over here, you'll notice just that it's saying, hey, first of all, you should connect this up to Supabase. So up top here, you can click this little Supabase button and just click connect to Supabase. I've happened to already connected my project, but I don't have it yet. So I'm going to come over here and click create project. You might have to log in or create a Supabase account if you don't have one yet. Now, once I've got that, let's give this a name. We're going to call it something like Portland Shoe Company. All right, I'll just keep it real short like that, and we'll generate a password. You just want this region to be closest to your end user, so I'll choose Northern California. When you click create new project, it's going to spin up this project and get everything ready for you. Now, you should see here, I've got this project status saying it's good, so we should be good to connect. So I'm going to close this down, come back over this way, and now select that PSC. Now it should connect the two, and then I can re-ask it to add that Resend functionality. All right, perfect. So back over here, now add the Resend functionality. Now what it will do is spin up a little function that Supabase will actually send for me that hits my Resend account. And again, it's going to ask me for a Resend API key because that's how it knows which Resend account to send from. Now, true to my word here, it's saying to add an API key. So I'm going to go over to my Resend account and just click on API keys. You don't have to have a paid account for this. You can use the free account just fine. I'll click create API key, and then we'll name this the same thing, Portland Shoe Company. All right, full access, all domains, that's all fine. I'll click add. And notice here, it's showing this with these dots to show that it's secure. I just want to come over here and click this copy button. And again, I don't want anyone to see this, so I'm not going to show it to you either. But now I can jump back over and click add API key, and I can just add it in directly here. Once again, Lovable kind of hides this as well, so I can just click submit, and all this gets stored securely in Supabase. Now, it should be able to build this function out that will then send an email whenever anybody fills out this form. But Lovable says it's finished. Let's click on code just to double check. And if I come over here, even if you're not super familiar with coding, this is fairly easy to read. You'll notice that what it's saying is it's going to use Resend, and it's going to use the email's kind of endpoint, and it will send an email from someone to someone. It'll have a subject and some HTML where we'll send their details. Now, notice up front here that this is using onboarding at resend.dev to send the email, and it can send it to anyone. Although I will warn you, by default, when you first start, you can only send it to your own Resend account. So let's come over here and just test this out, and we'll talk a little bit more about why that is. And then we'll come over here at chris@resend.com and hit send. Now, this should send off an email to me, and I can check it in a couple of different places. I can check it in my own email, and I can also check it in the Resend dashboard. So if we come over here and we go to emails, and let's just look at the last day. This is just today. You'll notice it did send me this from the Portland Shoe Company. If I click over here, it'll actually show me the message itself. And hey, that looks pretty good. So we've got something actually working. But once again, I can only send to myself to start with. And I can only send from onboarding at resend.dev. Now, the reason we do this is because it protects your own reputation. When email inboxes receive an email, they always check to make sure that whoever's sending that email is authorized to send on behalf of that domain. So we want to make sure that we connect our domain in Resend, which we'll only need to do once, and then we can swap around this to address and the from address to send anywhere we want from our own custom domain. So let me come to the domains over here. We'll just click add domain. You'll notice it says it recommends that you use a separate subdomain, and this again is another way of kind of gating off your reputation, because those email inboxes not only look at your full domain, but they also look at subdomains. And so if you have a problem with one subdomain, it can kind of stay isolated to that subdomain rather than tarnish the reputation of your entire domain. So in other words, you could use like transactional dot whatever or updates dot whatever. So in this case, I'm going to use something like contact. So I'll say contact.portlandshoecompany.com. Again, you can choose whatever region works best for your end users. In this case, most of mine, I'll assume, aren't going to be in the US since it's a Portland shoe company. And then I'll click Add Domain. Recent will give you a list of DNS records now. And the idea is that you're going to copy these records over to your DNS provider. Now, this is likely wherever you bought your domain through. In my case, I bought this from Namecheap, so that's what I'll be using. The tricky part here is that everyone is a little bit different, so we've provided guides for most of the major ones, but if you have any trouble, just reach out. We'll help you get started. You'll only need to do this once, and then your recent account can always send from this domain. So you'll notice over here, it's knowing that I got this from Namecheap, so I can actually click here and it will guide me through it step by step. But no matter what you're using, you'll see a list right here where you can add these manually. So the nice thing is that I can just click, and notice I get a little check mark to kind of track my progress. So let me jump over to Namecheap. I'm looking at Portland Shoe Company, and I want to click on Advanced DNS in my case. The first one I need to add is an MX record, and the way that Namecheap splits this up is everything else is up here, and just the MX records are down this way. So let's click Add New Record, and I'll paste this one in, and we'll just kind of jump back and forth, doing these one after the other. So next, we've got the data here. I'll jump back up, we'll paste this in the mail server, and I saw that the priority was 10, so we should be good. So I'll add that and save the changes. Okay, so back over here, we're going to now grab the two TXT records and add these as well. And I'll come up top here and add right here a new TXT record. Again, you're just gonna paste these one after the other. And here we go, the next one. I'll finish this out and be right back with you. All right, so you'll notice here I've added all of them. In fact, I even added the DMARC record down this way. That's best practice, so typically that's what I would recommend as well. And once you're done, you just need to click I've added the records and the process will start. Recent will check to make sure that those records actually exist, and then eventually we'll mark your domain as verified. And depending on how long that propagation takes, it could be like a minute or two, or it could be up to an hour or so. If you have any trouble, reach out to us. We'll make sure that you've got everything configured correctly and that you can connect your domain. So let's check, and you'll see that I created this 5 minutes ago, and the propagation only took about a minute or two once I clicked I've added my records. So now we can actually send from contact at Portland Shoe Company. So let's jump back to Lovable, and I'm gonna say something like, send from Portland Shoe Co. I'll say something like info at, and then we'll paste in that domain. That would be contact.portlandshoecompany.com. It has to match whatever you put inside Resend. So not Portland Shoe Company, but contact.portlandshoecompany.com. So it should now update that UDCH function to use my new value. So now that we've got everything connected, it should actually send from Portland Shoe Company, right? So that's what we want. So if you look over here, this is what it says it's done. You can actually view the code, and you'll see that that's exactly what it's done. It's updated it right here to now be from info@contact.portlandshoecompany.com. So we've got that all set up. Everything else should be just as is. I want to add a couple of other things. I'm going to say something like blind copy Chris at resend.com. And that way it always sends it to me as well in my own email inbox. Now you can put whatever inbox that you can receive emails at, but that's what I'm doing is using my own custom work account there. So if I scroll back down here, you'll see it's updating this. If I jump over here, now the BCC field is chris@resend.com. So now I know that it will send to me, and it will also send to the person who filled out the form. So let's now update this one more time. I'm going to come over here. We'll say something like Chris. And then here, let's just do like a sample. So we'll say like lovable@resend.com. And that should actually still work because I'm using Gmail in this case. Okay, so now that we're set and ready to go, let me jump over to Gmail and check that this has actually landed in my inbox. So over here in Gmail, you can see that I've actually got Portland Shoe Company showing up. And there it is. And it's sent to Chris. Plus Lovable from Portland Shoe Company. Now I could of course also look at this in the recent dashboard. So if I jump back over here, we look at emails, this most recent one right over here, right here. You can see that not only has it sent it to me, but it's also blind copied chris@resend.com. That's all working, but there's one more thing we want to talk about. We've actually gotten it to connect. Somebody can fill out a form. It sends them an email. It blind copies us. But what happens if they reply? Now, right now, Resend doesn't allow you to receive email, but you can actually guide somebody when they go to reply to always reply to a certain email address. So that's what we'll do next. So if I jump back over to Lovable, we'll say like, set the reply to email address to chris@resend.com. So in other words, when they hit reply, it will send it to chris@resend.com instead of that email inbox, since I don't actually have one set up at info@contact or whatever it was. Okay, so over here, you'll see that it's actually updated it. If I jump into the code, there it is, reply to chris@resend.com. Okay, cool. So let's go ahead and try this one more time. We'll say Chris. We'll do Chris plus Lovable, why not, @resend.com and hit send message. Now I should be able to jump over to my email inbox and check that out. And in fact, I think I saw a notification down there, but I just swiped it away. So yep, there we go. I pulled this up, chris@lovable. Here's the second one, I think it is. And now notice when I click reply here, it says chris@recent.com. Now, if I were to come up here and go reply, you'll notice that it tries to send it to this address, which doesn't actually exist, which is why we added that extra little step. Well, I hope this helps you understand kind of how it works under the hood, how you can connect Resend and Lovable to send somebody an email when they do some kind of action on your site. Now, Resend also includes a full marketing feature where you can actually interact with a Notion style editor to write marketing updates as well. The transactional, that's what we've worked on today, and the marketing together allow you to send emails however you want to your customers. Well, thanks for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Happy sending.